In this video, I wanted to go over this Euclid stuff with the little kids because, quite honestly, they may not understand about equal angles and that kind of stuff, and they may not really be understanding what I'm trying to do here. Now, first of all, we have a compass. As you can plainly see here, this is the compass. It has a sharp metal point here, which you will put on the center of any circle that you try to draw. It will also have a lead point, which you will put on the circumference. Now, what is the circumference of a circle? Well, simply put, it's the outermost edge of any circle. All right, so the outermost edge of any circle is the circumference, and the center of the circle is right here. Now, what we did was we measured this thing out. We opened it up to the point where we, you can see here, I'm going to get it like that. And we measured out this distance. Now, keep in mind, Euclid did not use number distances. He just didn't do that. But in order for the kids to understand all this stuff, we're going to use distances. Now, as you'll see here, line AB is 2¼ inches in length, okay? And what we did was we put the compass here on centermost part A, outermost part B, and we drew a circle. All right, now I know it's kind of hard to see, but we actually drew a circle. And then we did the same thing from B to A. We drew yet another circle. And by doing so, the radii of a circle. Now, a radius of a circle is basically when you draw a line between the centermost part of the circle, which in this case was A, to its outermost edge, which in this case was B. And we said that that length was 2½ inches long, or 2¼ inches long. Now, anytime you draw a line from the center of the circle to its outermost edge, it doesn't matter whether you draw it way up here, or way over here, or way down here. Doesn't matter. The point is that those lengths are going to be exactly the same. So the line AB is 2¼ inches in length. The line AC is also 2¼ inches in length. Now, we drew another circle and it was from B to A. B was the center, A was the outermost edge or the circumference. All right. And after we drew the second circle, we came up with a length of 2¼ inches between B and A, and 2¼ inches between B and C. All right? And what happened was that since AB and BA are 2¼ inches in length, and AB and AC are 2¼ inches in length, and BC and BA are also 2¼ inches in length, that made this triangle an equilateral triangle. All right, and we can use this equilateral triangle to draw equally straight lines. And we did this on the next page. We had a line from point A to point B, and it was 2¼ inches. No, it was actually 2½ this time. We had a line from point A to point B, and it was 2½ inches in length. And then we had a lonely little point C, and what we wanted to do was we wanted to draw a line from point C to some other point, which we ended up calling F, that was going to be exactly the same length as AB. And the way we did this is we drew an equilateral triangle. We drew two circles from A to C. A was the center, C was the outermost edge. We drew another circle from C to A, making C the center, A the outermost edge. And by drawing these two circles together, we were able to make an equilateral triangle. We extended out the equilateral triangle from point D all the way down to point E. All right? And we said that the length of AC was 1½ inches in length. And because this was an equilateral triangle, the length of AD was 1½. The length of CD was 1½. And so therefore, each one of these sides of triangle ADC, this is triangle ADC, each one of these sides are going to be 1½ inches in length. All right. Now, what we did then was we drew another circle. We had the innermost center part A, And we had outermost point B, this would be the circumference of circle A, and we made another circle, and went through B, and when we did, we drew the radius, and it was 2.5 inches in length. Now, we drew this all the way down, and we had the length of AB cross the length of AE. And so therefore, AE also became 2.5 inches in length. And that's because when you subtract equals from equals, and here's how this one worked. You have 2.5 inches here, and 1.5 here. That makes 4 inches. The length of DE is 4 inches long. The length of DA is 1.5 inches, so if we subtract 1.5 inches from 4 inches, we have a length from A to E, which is 2.5 inches. And now, since we know that the length of AB and AE are equal, if we were to take centermost part D and outermost part E and make another circle and cross it at F, then we have a length from D to F that is also 4 inches long. So D, E, and DF are 4 inches long. We've already said that DC is 1.5 inches long, so subtracting 1.5 inches from 4 inches leaves us with 2.5 inches, which is, by the way, the length of AB. So AB is equal in length to CF. And that's all she wrote, folks. All right, I will cover more in a future video, so stay tuned.